Quitting smoking is not easy. It's a decision that you personally have to make for yourself. And maybe it's the reason why I failed in my attempts before, because I wasn't doing it because I wanted to. I was doing it because people around me were saying, quit, it's not good for you, why do you smoke?
But being held accountable
and telling my parents and my grandmother and the people around me that I'm quitting really helped me this time, and not doing it on my own.
Les voy a dar unos tips para poder dejar de fumar que a mí me hicieron bien, me sirvieron bastante.
Los hábitos que ya tenés de los cigarrillos que ya fumás y que te parecen imprescindibles. Eso se puede disminuir la cantidad hasta llegar a cero. En los momentos de más tensión o de más estrés o de más angustia, que es cuando solía fumar más. Bueno, en esos momentos tenés que buscar otra forma de canalizarlo. O te comes un chocolate, o tratás de mentalizarte. Y bueno, si no podés más, entonces tratás de pedir una ayuda a un profesional para poder canalizar esas ansiedades y el estrés de otra manera.
Overcoming the urge to smoke and how I battled with those temptations has really been a challenge, but I can say that what is helping with that is surrounding yourself with people who are supporting you and who are there for you when you just need to say, you know what, today I had a bad day. I did feel like I could have done with a cigarette on that day, but I am proud that I didn't. So people who knows what you're going through and supports you is just very motivating and helps you overcome that urge and that temptation.
For me, it was very helpful to substitute certain things to fill in that void of the habit. When I would be working, or I would be speaking, or I would be nervous, or I would be excited, I will always reach out for a cigarette. But instead of doing this, I'm kind of in the back of my mind, I know that this is the moment where you need to fill in something. And this is where, for me, for instance, I started to have snacks, but I go on healthy snacks, no? Nuts, almonds, water, juice. It helps a lot to overcome that first phase when it's the most difficult, that you keep on forgetting that you quit.
So the healthy habits that I'm trying to bring is, of course, diverting my mind with foods that are good and healthy and also tasty. So I make those, that action of making sort of diverts my mind. Secondly, I've also realized like the craving is the strongest when I have a heavy day of work and I wrap up work. So instead of heading out to my balcony with my tea and, you know, a smoke, I'm actually trying to work out. Yesterday I worked out. I was sweating, muscles were hurting, but the workout session completely changed my craving. Like there was no craving. It goes away and my focus completely shifts.
هلا من الأدوات اللي ساعدتني إني أنا أقلع عن التدخين هي كانت عبارة عن لزقتي النيكوتين أول. ثانيا كنت أنسى المحفظة أخذ مثلا إشي بسيط منها بحيث ما يكفيني إني أشتري بكة دخان. أنا بنسى الفلوس، ما راح أقدر إني أروح على السوبر ماركت أشتري مثلا بكة دخان، أو أضلني أطلب إذا كان في إلي زميل إلي مدخن إني أضلني إني أطلب منه دخان، لأن أول مرة راح يعطيني سيجارة، ثاني مرة راح يعطيني سيجارة، بس إنه لبعدين يعني راح تصير الشغلة إنك أنت تتضايق من جوا إنه أنت قاعد تطلب دخان من شخص ثاني. فهاي الشغلة هي يعني صارت عندي إنه حب التحدي، وصار في عندي كمان يعني أدوات ساعدتني هاي. يعني أنا بالنسبة لي قررت بهاي الأدوات اللي ساعدتني، هيك بكون يعني صارت عندي شغلة كتير أفضل بهاي الأدوات، ساعدتني بشكل كبير إني أتخلص من عادة التدخين.
También es recomendable tener algún hobby. A mí me gusta pintar cuadros. No sé si lo hago bien o lo hago mal, pero me gusta hacerlo. La finalidad es poder estar ocupada en una actividad que me reconforta y que me hace olvidar de prender un cigarrillo.
有助于抵御吸烟的措施呢，就是说，当你决定戒烟的那一天起，我希望呢，就是说。 所有的吸烟者能够将自己身边的所有有关香烟的东西全部丢掉，包括打火机，包括香烟盒。那么我平时呢，对于我的戒烟过程来说，其实我把戒烟当做一种挑战吧，当做一种意志力的一个挑战，到底是意志的胜利，还是尼古丁的胜利？包括我的一些朋友，他们会知晓我戒烟之后已经有5个月了，然后他们都会感到不可思议，很难成功的一件事情，但是你做到了，那么对于自己的一个自信心的提升呢，是一个有很大的帮助的。
There's somebody at this moment that is sitting and watching this video and thinking, should I do it or should I not? I have only one argument. You should do it, and you should do it really soon, because every single day, every single hour that you're not doing this, you're missing out on a totally different world of sensations, of feelings, of taste, of yourself. You deprive your family, your friends, your loved ones of a better you.
The moment you take that decision that I am going to stop this, and you do plan on working on it every day, that's when you win. Because burning your lungs every day does not make sense. And I have been successful so far. And trust me, if I can do it, if one person can do it, I'm sure that you can too.
I think a lot of people don't realize when you quit the side effects and the repercussions that come thereafter that you have to go through as well. And I went through those and I still go through those. But my advice would be, see it through. You're doing it and you're feeling this way because your body is now adjusting to a different lifestyle, a better lifestyle. So remind yourself of that aspect when you're going through it and you aren't sure whether or not you're able to see it through. Remind yourself of the good that will come out of it and how it will impact your life.